All right, Rose here again, part two. Had some caretaking to do first. So, in this comment thread that I'm in right now, somebody said, oh, I think that person is at the beginning of their journey. Well, to that person and to many others, I'd say, yeah, sounds like a lot of y'all are at the beginning of your journeys. And highly on doing a lot of spiritual bypassing, which thinks it's at a higher level than it really is. And it's a real thing you got to deal with. Let's see. So we finished off this last one about the white spiritual goddess with a whale on the hook. We got us a wallet on the hook. We've got us an attention on the hook. What were we fishing for? We were fishing for money. We were fishing for ego, prestige. We're hooking attention. And when we create those hooks, and if we create hooks, then the person either has to free themselves or we have to free them. And we actually hurt people when we hook them. Unless we're teaching them how to be unhook themselves, then we're making them dependent upon us for something. What is that? So when I went to this person's page, it said, what I see is a bunch of sending of love and light, which comes from a place of lack. If you're having to send something to someone, then they're lacking it. And boy, is that like projection in this particular situation. And then the commands afterwards. So you've hooked attention and then you're giving commands. You're not even saying like, perhaps we could do this, or I think we would do well to do this. You're issuing commands, and probably from a place of fear, and trying to control the world to make you comfortable, perhaps. So if we're a sexy goddess, are we hooking men? Are we hooking women? And are we hooking them back into the patriarchy? Or are we hooking them outside to get outside? Are we trying to make them look like us? Or are we steering them towards something that would look better? That would be better for the whole? Are we doing this merely for our own benefit? And if so, like, you know, might want to look at service to self versus service to others, and at least make sure this is in a balance. Then I saw on this page where they were doing sound healing. I really want to send a message here that be very, very careful with sound. And being put into altered states, and be very, very sure that the person that is healing you has healed themselves, because they cannot transmit anything that they do not have, and they very well may be being an unconscious agent of something that you don't want to be hooked into, and inserting that while you're in this altered state. So if you're in your altered states, be very, very conscious while you're in there of what is going on, and that you are participating in some other planes. If you're steering somebody to be like you, what are you being like? What are you being like? Are you really being an embodiment of the decolonized self, decolonized as much as possible? Are you raising up voices which are getting squished all the time, and just speaking so loud that nobody can hear them? You know, if we all turned around and just as much as we talk ourselves, and talking about ourselves is also important, but we need to be talking about ourselves as far as how we're decolonizing ourselves, perhaps, so that others follow us into that, into learning how to decolonize ourselves, learning how to be better allies, learning how to break out of systems versus how to make money. You know, honestly, you can't make money. The government, like, you'll go to jail. It's felony to make money. You've got a program there. You're very early on your journey and you're still not even decolonized your speech to where you can begin creating good spells. If you're using words like need, make, have to, if you're coming from, a colonized mindset, and if you have not detached yourself from the colonized mindset, you are not even beginning to spread some kind of love or light. You're spreading disease. You're spreading a virus. So, yeah, that came out again. Then, they ended with a ho. Oh my gosh. Let's not do that as white people, please. White spiritual people. Let's not do that. Let's not do that. Let's not do that. Standing Rock, I got quite educated on that one. And my general takeaway, everybody has a different take on everything, but my general takeaway after that was, ain't no way I'm using that word, because it seems to be a way to mark the ones that are spiritually bypassing and have not decolonized themselves at all and are misappropriating. Yeah, there's a lot of controversy around that word, and best to just bypass using somebody else's words unless you really, really, really understand them. So, a few little notes there to white spiritual goddesses. Share your clothes. Like, how about cleaning out your closet and going where you only have 3 outfits for a while? Can you still be a goddess and be homeless? Can you still be a goddess without your fancy clothes? Can you still be a goddess without makeup? Can you let your hair grow and not go to the gym for a month and get dirty, like not take a shower for a while and not use the razors and put those into mama and still be a goddess? Don't be pissing off the real goddess, playing gaudy goddess. So, goddess, gaudiness, be careful. Be full of care as you're, what you're putting out into the world would be my, and calling love. You know, light, Walmart has light. It's really harsh and hard. And, we got enough of that. We can't even see the freaking Milky Way for light pollution. So perhaps turn off the lights and go into the dark for a bit. Peace, love, and aloha. Rose.